It's the most wonderful time of the year, the winter edition of the Queer Lit Readathon. What's up, friends? The Queer Lit Readathon is back again for round 6, and today I'm going to share with you my TBR. If you haven't heard the Queer Lit Readathon, this was created by Kathy and Rogan, and their co-host this round is R. I will have all the host links and information for the readathon down below. Every round, there's a rainbow bingo board with the challenges, so I'm going to go ahead and get right into my TBR. As always, check my description for updated petitions and donation links. Because this week is Thanksgiving, I'm going to provide a donation link where you can split donate to food banks across the US. Because of the pandemic, the food banks need donations more than ever, so if you can donate, please do. Let's get into my TBR. The first book I'm going to be reading is for the Create Your Own Challenge prompt, and for this, I am going to be using it as a debut novel, and this is The Black Flamingo by Dean Atta. I think this could also work for Host Rec because I know that Kathy gave this a 5-star, so that could work. I have heard so many good things about this. I was watching a book launch panel with Dean on it, and he talked all about his book, and I am just so excited for this. It is about a boy who does drag, and I also know it's in verse, but that's all I really know about it. The majority of books on my TBR are ebooks, except one physical book. So I got this from Overdrive. It says it's coming in on the 27th, so I'll have it just in time for the readathon. The next challenge completes 3 challenges, first being to read an Ace or Arrow main character, a main character that's not like you, and Winter Vibes. And this is the last book on my Indigathon TBR, Alatoway by Darcy Little Badger. It completes all of those. But it's kind of paranormal because Alatoway can actually see the ghosts of animals who have died, and that sounds so cool. I actually talk about it more in depth in my Indigathon TBR, so I'll have that linked above if you haven't seen it yet. This could also work for Own Voices because Darcy Little Badger is asexual, and she is also a citizen of the Lapeach and Apache tribe of Texas. Next, I have 2 graphic novels that could work for the graphic novel prompt. I'm just not sure which one I'm going to get to yet. I have BB Free by Gabby Rivera, which is on Hoopla, and I have a copy of A Quick and Easy Guide to Queer and Trans Identities. So this is a quick graphic novel. I have BB Free on Hoopla, and I really am trying to save my Hoopla credits for December because I'm doing 2 secret TBRs. So we'll see what happens with that, but I might just read this one because it's physical and I have it. So either way, I'm going to be reading a graphic novel. I'm just not sure which one yet. The next book completes group read, queer friends, and non-coming out story, and this is The Summer of Everything by Julian Winters. I am so excited to read this. I read Running with Lions a while back, and I just can't wait to read this. I also saw Julian talk about this on Audrey's channel. I'll try and link it down below. I really enjoyed just hearing about the book. That's just one of my favorite things, is that I just like to hear why the book was written and just the author's thought process. I think it's just a writer thing, but I'm always just curious why they wrote it, and so I really enjoyed that interview. Next, I have an e-arc for a book that comes out in 2021. This completes the prompt pre/non-medical transition and see yourself, and this is Between Perfect and Real by Ray Stove, and I am so excited for this. It is about a trans guy who is very much in the closet. This is a coming out story. This is about him being in the closet but being out as a lesbian and just gender identity, and I feel like I'm going to be able to resonate with this a lot. I heard it's really good and I am just so excited to read this. I think it comes out in March. I'll have the pub date on the screen because I don't know exactly what the date is, but I am very excited to get to this one. And last, I have to read a book with a BIPOC main character, and this is going to be King and the Dragonflies by Kacen Callender. I meant to get to this in September, but I just didn't because I was reading for Latinx Heritage Month, and this was for the middle grade book club, and I just never got around to it. But I love Kacen. They are one of my favorite authors that I found this year, and this is a middle grade about a boy who is questioning sexuality and he's also going through the grieving process as he just lost his brother. And so, you know, I'm gonna love that book because it's very on brand for me. So that's it for my TBR. I'm actually not going to be vlogging this round. I usually do, but I'm going to be doing 2 reading vlogs in December, and I just don't want to burn myself out, but I'm very excited for them. So hit subscribe if you haven't, and turn on my bell notifications so that you'll be notified when those videos come out. If you have any end of the year videos that you'd like to see me do, please comment them down below. I'm just looking for some ideas of just videos that I could post. I am going to be doing the end of the year book tag, so don't worry about that. But if you have any recommendations for maybe like holiday videos that you would like to see, I'm also going to be doing a book recommendations that was a request. So stay tuned for my channel in December. It's going to be lit. So that's it for today's video. If you are participating in the Queer Lit Readathon, let me know what books you're going to be reading or just what book you're excited for. I love this readathon because it doesn't encouraged to read queer lit throughout the year, which you should be doing anyway, but I hope that you will participate if you can, and definitely go and check out the readathon if you haven't. All of the hosts are great and I love their content, and if you're looking for more queer lit recommendations, they've got you covered. I hope you're all having a great day, staying safe, and I will see you next time. Bye.